But first to the Solomons, there are fears the death toll from severe flooding in the Solomon Islands will rise as the weather worsens. At least 16 people have died in flooding in the capital, Honiara, as heavy rain from the tropical depression caused the Mataniko River to burst its banks, washing away houses. It's now a disaster zone and evacuation shelter has been set up for 10,500 people. The government's declared a state of emergency and New Zealand has already announced it will provide $300,000 in aid. We have Cameron Vudi, the Solomon Islands Red Cross Disaster Manager, on the line from Honiara. Cameron, thanks for joining us. So is this the worst disaster to hit the Solomon Islands? How bad is it right now?
It is quite bad at the moment in Honiara. I think this is the worst disaster we've had in Honiara since Cyclone Namu back in the mid 80s. As you have mentioned earlier, there are confirmed deaths and. There is a possibility that this might increase once the weather clears. And today is the first day that there are signs of the weather clearing. And so possibly we could carry out more work, cover more areas and work today.
So what's the most urgent need for the people in Honiara?
Just from information gathered from our teams that have been sent out to the evacuation sites. So the government has set up and the Honiara City Council has set up evacuation centres in different parts of Honiara. And we have a lot of people living in these camps. So but the information getting back to us is that they immediately need clothes, warm clothes, blankets and food and water, and also I think sanitation, especially for some of the camps which have a lot more people with very little sanitation facilities available to them.
I know we've got a small Solomon Islands community here in New Zealand. Where can people get information about relatives?
They can get information about relatives from the NDMO, and also we, Solomon Islands Red Cross, we have a program called Restoring Family Links. So what they can do is contact the Solomon Islands Red Cross about if they are concerned about different family members, and we have mechanisms in place that could be used to track down family members and also in letting them know that they are safe.
Okay, well, thank you, Cameron, for your time. Our thoughts are with your people.